Hello friends, welcome to TextDigiCell. In this video, I will make a ESP32 home automation project using the new Blink IoT platform. I have already made a similar project using ESP8266 NodeMCU. After that, I have received lot of requests to make the same project using ESP32 and 8 channel relay module. So I will cover that in this video, and I will highly recommend you to watch the complete video as I have shared all the required information for this project during the video. In this project, I am going to use this PCB, but you can also make this project just by using ESP32, 8 channel relay module, and to control these relays manually, you can use this type of 2 pin push button or any latch switch. So in the switch, you can see this is the common ground and these wires will connect with the ESP32 GPIO. So this is a very simple connection I have made to use this switch. I will also share the circuit diagram. So you need this component to make this project. This is the complete circuit diagram for this project. Here you can see I have given the 5 volt supply to ESP32 and a relay module. Now if you want to connect any latch switch, then you can refer this circuit. Here you can see I have connected these switches across the GPIO pin of ESP32 and the ground. And this is the 5 volt control circuit, and you can refer this circuit to connect the 220 volt appliances with the relay module. And the control pin of the relay module is connected with the ESP32 GPIO as per this circuit. Now here you can see there are a lot of connections, so please make sure there should not be any loose connection if you use jumper wire to connect ESP32 with the relay module. Now to avoid any loose connection, I am going to use this PCB. But as I said, you can also make this project without using any custom design PCB. Still, if you want to get this custom design PCB, then download the GABA file from the video description and order it from the JLC PCB. You can order any custom design PCB from JLC PCB with 3 simple steps. First, upload the GABA file. Then select the parameter like quantity, PCB masking color, then place the order. If you select faster delivery service, then you will get the PCB within a week. And as you can see, the quality of the PCB is very premium in this affordable price range. So you can always try JLC PCB for your any custom design PCB project. Now these are the components required for the PCB. Now I will quickly solder all the components on the PCB. Now let me connect it with the laptop to program the ESP32 for this project. These are the codes for this project. If you use any momentary switch or button for this project, then you have to refer this code. And for the latch switch, you have to refer this code. Here you can see I have mentioned switch in the name of the code. Now you can easily download these codes from my website iotcircuithub.com. Just visit the article link given in the description, then you can download the code from this button. After downloading the code, you have to keep all the 10 files in the same directory. Then open this Arduino sketch. This is the code for the latch switch. Now before uploading the code, let me go to the setting.h header file. And here I have defined GPIO2 as a board LED pin. Now if I go to the config.mode.h header file and scroll down to the last line, here you can see I have commented this line to control the appliances without internet. So if you uncomment the line, although ESP32 will automatically connect with the Wi-Fi, but you cannot control the appliances without internet as it will keep on restarting after every 1 minute. So to control the appliances without internet, I have commented this line. Now I have to update the Blink template ID and the device name. For that, I have to go to the Blink Cloud account. In the Blink Cloud account, first I will go to templates. Now I have used this template in my previous ESP32 projects. Here you can see I have made all this data stream and web dashboard. So here I don't need this temperature and humidity reading. So I will create a clone of this template and I will give a name, say ESP32 Smart Home. Then I will go to data stream. So here I need only 9 data stream, so I don't need this data stream for temperature and humidity. So let me delete all this data stream. You can refer my previous video to create all this data stream web dashboard. I have explained all the details in that video. So here I am deleting all the data stream created for the sensor, as I am not going to use any sensor. I will just control 8 relays, so I need 9 data stream only. And with this CMOD data stream, I will turn off all the relays at a time. So total 9 data stream I will use for this project, which is V1 to V9. Now let me go to the web dashboard, and here I will also delete the widget for temperature and humidity reading. So our data stream and web dashboard is ready. Now I have to click on clone, and here you can see a new clone is created from this old template. Now I have to copy this template ID and device name and go to Arduino sketch and paste it here. And for this project, you just need the ESP32 board and the Blink library. You can refer these two links. So after doing this much of changes, you can directly upload the code to ESP32. For that, go to tools, select the board as do it ESP32 dev kit V1 and select the proper port, then hit the upload button. Now here I am using the free Blink account, where you can connect only a single device. So before connecting the ESP32 with the Blink cloud account, first you have to go to my device. You can click here, then go to my device, and from here first you have to delete the previous device which is already connected. So here you can see currently no device is connected, so I can configure the mobile dashboard and connect the ESP32 with this Blink cloud account. So for that I have to open the Blink IoT app, then I have to log in to Blink cloud account. So first I have to add this ESP32 with the Blink cloud account. So I will tap on add new device, select connect to Wi-Fi. Then here you can see this Wi-Fi indicator is blinking. So let me tap on ready. During this time this LED should blink, and then select this hotspot created by this ESP32. Then you have to select a Wi-Fi network and enter the password for that Wi-Fi network. Then tap on continue. Here you can also change the name. So let me give the ESP32 smart home. Then tap on continue. Then again tap on continue. Tap on done. Then tap on finish and exit. Now I have to set up the mobile dashboard. So I will tap on setup dashboard. So from this 3-dash icon, I have to add 8 button widget to control 8 relays. After that, to turn off all the relays, I will add another button widgets. Let me resize the last button widgets. So I have added total 9 button widgets. So let me tap on the first button widget, and in the data stream, I will select switch 1 to control relay 1 from this button, and the mode will be switch. Then exit from this first button. So in this way you have to configure the first 8 button to control 8 relays. After that I will tap on the 9th button, and here I will select the data stream C mode, which I will use to turn off all the relays together, and here the mode will be push. So our mobile dashboard is ready. Now I will exit from the setup mode. Now let me control the relays from this dashboard, and you can see I can easily control all the relays, and if I tap here, all the relays will turn up together. I have connected these 8 lamps and these switches with the PCB as per the circuit, and this blue LED is glowing, which indicates the ESP32 is connected with the Wi-Fi. So I can control it from the Blink IoT app. You can see I can easily control these lamps from this Blink IoT app. And I can use this button to turn off all the lamps together. Now let me control the appliances from this manual switch. And you can monitor the real-time feedback in the Blink IoT app. Now I will turn off the Wi-Fi and show you how it works without Wi-Fi. Now before turning off the Wi-Fi, you can see the first 4 lamp is glowing. Now let me turn off the Wi-Fi. After turning off the Wi-Fi, you can see this blue LED is blinking rapidly, which indicates now the ESP32 is not connected with the Wi-Fi, but still I can control the appliances manually from this manual switch. But I cannot monitor the real-time feedback in the Blink IoT app as the ESP32 is not connected with the Blink server. So now I will turn on the Wi-Fi again. After turning on the Wi-Fi, I have to manually switch off all the appliances. Then I have to press the reset button of ESP32. Now here you can see it is fetching the previous state from the Blink server after connecting with the Wi-Fi, and the blue LED is now glowing. And now I can control the appliances from the Blink IoT app as it is connected with the internet. And I can also monitor the real-time feedback in the Blink IoT app. If you like this project, then please give a thumbs up and share it with your friends. And don't forget to subscribe for more such projects. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.